Okay, so today I'm going to be doing a real quick oil change on my 2012 R1. This will work on anything from 2009 to current R1, basically this procedure, but I follow the same process for every bike that I do, or vehicle really. The oil that I use is the 10W40 AMS oil, and I also use their EAOM103 filter black. They also offer it in a chrome, but I just use a black because where mine's located on this bike that you'll see here in a little bit, it wouldn't make much sense to do chrome because you're not gonna be able to see it anyway. So the tools you're gonna need is you're gonna need the oil filter socket is what I call it. This is just an AmPro that I picked up at, I think, O'Reilly Auto Parts. They had them. Basically what you want to do is you want to take in or grab your oil filter, walk in with it, and make sure it fits. I can't remember the specific size for this, so apologize, I might put it in the description if I find out what it is. What you'll also need is a 17 millimeter socket. That's for the drain plug. You'll need a few extensions, a ratchet, and then you'll also need a 4 millimeter Allen key, or an Allen wrench. Basically, I have a key set that's metric, and I also have one that's standard. Makes it really nice when you're working on these bikes, just because there's so many different sizes, and typically the Yamahas are completely metric. Actually, I'd be surprised if you found one standard bolt on it. And then you'll also need the key to your bike. I start my bike up and I warm it up for about 5-10 minutes or so until it gets about to the 200 mark and holds consistent. I also try to feel the side of the clutch cover once that starts to get pretty hot, and then I understand that the oil is getting warm because your bike could be at 200 degrees Fahrenheit, but it doesn't mean the oil is warm. So one thing I want to make sure is that the oil is getting up to temperature. Basically, if you've ever used or ever had syrup before, cold syrup versus warm syrup, you can tell the difference in viscosity. The cold syrup is going to be a lot thicker than the warm syrup, so oil is going to work the same way. Warmer oil is going to be a little bit more thinner. It's going to bring out more of the contaminants and everything else that's in the oil when it's warm, because it actually gets to move through the motor, it gets to start moving that stuff around again, and then it'll drop it down into your oil pan or your catch pan, which is another thing that you're going to need. This is just a small one that I have, so yeah, there's not a lot to it. I recommend anyone doing this themselves, because a dealer is going to charge you a lot of money to get this done in comparison to what you could spend doing it yourself. You know, do it yourself, buy higher quality oil. A lot of guys are running the Castrol stuff. Some guys are running the Mobil 1 4T. I've ran that for a while, but I switched over to AMS oil a few years ago, and that's the way to go for me, honestly. Shifts a lot smoother, runs a lot nicer from what I can tell, and it's quality stuff. They've done the research. You can see all the oil studies and everything else, independent studies, and they're up there as, you know, number one, number two most of the time. So anyways, I'm gonna get into it here. Be back with you in a second. Okay, so I'm gonna call that good. Basically, my fuel test is always done by the oil level. If I can lay my hand up against that and it gets pretty warm, to me that's good. It means the oil is nice and liquid-like, more thin than what it would be if it was cold. So basically, the first step is going to be to remove the lower left and right fairings. Basically, there's really 8 bolts holding that on. You've got 1, 2, 3, you've got that on the other side as well, and then you've got lead two, one there and one there. You're gonna remove this, these lower pieces. And there's a trick to removing these too, and I'll get to that here in a second. They kind of slide in so you can get it in there. That's all the pieces that you're gonna need to remove on this bike to be able to get the oil change done correctly. Once I get all these loosened up, I'll come back and I'll show you guys the trick to kind of sliding those in and out, because there's a bracket right in here that it slides into. So I'll be back in 1 second. Okay, so I just removed the left side of the bike, which left me with the right side, as you can kind of see there. So I've got these two up here loose. You gotta loosen up that bottom one there. So I'll go ahead and do that here real quick. And that's it. They're quick release, quarter turn stuff. Pretty simple. So, like I was saying, with this bracket, there's a special way of getting these out. You just don't yank it straight back. You've literally got to take the panel and watch. It'll slide down just like that. It's got like a slotted bracket, and I'll show you that here in a second. That's all you got to do to loosen up that panel. But one thing you want to make sure you do is you want to remove this top portion first. It's got these little tabs on it that kind of, right. So the gloss panel's got little tabs that actually go into the tabs on this lower panel. So like I said, you slide this thing forward and then it will come right out of that bracket. So let me hold on to this panel here and show it to you. You can see how the right side, let's see if it'll focus. No, that might be about as good as it'll get. For some reason my autofocus is going all over the place. But you can see how the right side of this bracket has a bigger opening than the left. So basically when you put it in, you'll slide it this way. When you take it out, you'll slide it that way. And like I said, that is all you've got to do to remove everything you need to get to do the oil change. So you've got one trick I've kind of learned too is that if you buy OEM panels ever in your lifetime, it's going to come in this really nice wrapper. I hold on to it because the inside's got like a microfiber feel. And anytime I'm working on the bike, I will throw my panels on that so they don't get scratched or whatever. I did hear one bolt come bouncing off this way. So I'm gonna grab this. Sometimes it will actually pop out of the panel that you're working on. So set it over here by the panel so I don't lose it. Okay, so next step is going to be to remove the drain plug, which is on the left side of the bike if you're sitting on it, right side if you're looking at it. And it is this bolt right there. And it's a 17 millimeter. So I'm gonna grab my drain pan, grab my ratchet, and loosen it up here. So I'll be right back. Okay, so I've gotten it loosened up with my ratchet, which by the way, I want to mention this is probably my favorite ratchet because it's got basically built-in extension to it. You pull down this little collar here and it'll extend out pretty nice. Comes in, I can't even begin to explain how many times this has saved me. So anyways, I took my 17 millimeter socket. I am loosening up the drain plug. Now be careful, if you have a catch pan that's got a big hole, you don't want your drain plug or your drain bolt, your drain plug to actually go into it. That would suck, because you'd have to tear it open and get into it. So anyways, there. Now the oil's draining. I'm gonna set the drain plug to the side. One thing I always do is I try to throw something down. I'm pretty good at changing the oil, but as you can see there, you know, there's a couple drops. I always try to put something down to catch the accidents. So I'm gonna let this drain. You can see it's pretty clean. looks really good. I always like to run my fingers through it a little bit, see if I can feel any grit, anything like that. You know, any excess stuff. You know, they sell magnetic drain plugs. I just haven't gotten around to it. So I will probably pick one up in the future. Maybe not. I don't know. We'll see. But looks good. I'm not seeing any like major fibers or anything like that, so that's a good thing. Gonna let this drain for a little bit here. I'm not gonna get too anal about it yet, because what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put that plug back in into the drain hole so that I can move this without oil getting everywhere. And then I'm actually going to loosen up the oil filter to relieve some pressure in the system, and that's gonna drain oil into this too as well. Then when I'm done, I'm going to come back and loosen up this again and let the excess oil drain. It'll allow it to collect and because it's a pressurized system, whether you want to believe it or not, because it's a closed system. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to, like I said, remove the oil filter, which will allow another place for air to escape, and it'll let more oil drain into the pan and get more bad stuff out of there. So I'm going to put this drain plug back in. Also, be careful if you do this and your oil's really hot. It might end, gets a couple like second, third degree burns on your hands. Mine's hot, but it's nothing I can't stand, which is good. It's like the perfect temp, to be honest with you. Okay, so that's back in. I'm gonna get to the oil filter and I'll be back with you guys in a second. Okay, so now it is time to actually take off the filter. Basically, the filter on the R1 is in the header, in between the headers there. Crap, let's see if I can get a good shot of it. You can kind of see it through there. You can see the actual coolant pump. And then you can see the oil filter right there. So what I do is I work on the left side of the bike, so clutch side of the bike, or clutch, it'd be actually be the brake side of the bike if you're looking at the levers, clutch side, clutch cover side of the bike. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put this on the oil filter itself with my hand through this side of the bike, through that gap right there. And then once I get this on, I'm gonna take these extensions, fish them through the header, like that, and get on the actual oil filter and then be able to twist it off. I actually can't remember if I do this with the front stand on this bike or not. I might have to take the front stand down and turn the wheel to be able to get the extension in there, but we'll find out. I'm going to get to that here in a second. Once I get that on, I will be back. Okay, so I've got the oil filter wrench on, or socket on. You can see there at the extension coming off right there, and there's the extension. Then the extension comes through the headers there, and then what I'll do is I'll take my ratchet, put it on the end of it, loosen it up. Now I have some plastic wrap that I get for free, but it's relatively cheap anywhere you go. But I usually lay that down along the header because that's literally, that oil filter is literally going to drain right in here, right on top of the header. It's not going to hurt anything if you don't put anything there. It'll just smoke like crazy probably for the first 15 minutes after you start it up till all that oil burns off, which isn't going to hurt anything. It's a titanium header. I mean, it's going to stain it on the top, but nothing that you're ever going to see. So completely up to you whether you want to use this trick or not. So, like I said, I'm gonna loosen that up here, and then, I'll be right back. Okay, so I have gotten the oil filter loosened up. It's drained, it's good to go, get ready to pull it off. Now, most oil filter sockets that I have found, it's a really, really tight fit. Let me put it that way. It's a really tight fit to get the oil filter out of the header. So I always take the oil filter socket off once it's loose, because these have a way of getting jammed on the oil filter, and if you pull it off, you have no leverage to yank it off. I mean, there's not a lot of room to get your hand in there. So I make sure it's loose enough to where I can twist it with my hand, and then I pull this off of the oil filter itself. Once that's off the oil filter, then I'm able to, again, see if I can do this, holding the camera somehow. Okay, so I'm gonna have to hold this with a towel because my hands are got oil on it, but so what I'm gonna do is I'm going to reach in here, finish it off with my hand, as bad as that sounds, no pun intended. Okay, and then take it and then wiggle it out through this gap right here, which it fits out perfectly through. And then there's going to be a little excess, and I, you know, dump it out. Now, one thing to keep in mind is that this stays extremely hot for a long time because there's coolant in there, and the coolant stays really, 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 really warm. So if you warm up your bike and you do this quickly, like it should be, I can, and you go in here and you lay your hand against it, there's a good chance you might burn your hand right there. So be careful. Okay, next is putting the oil filter, new oil filter on, and I'll get to prepping that here in a second. Okay, so we've got the old filter out, which is right here, new filter here. Basically what I do before I put it on is I put a nice ring coating of oil around the gasket that's on the outside. Keeps it from getting dry rotted, all that good stuff. Most oil filters that go in a vertical situation, I will pre-fill all the way pretty much to the top if I can get it in there without it spilling, but since this filter literally goes in like this, I can only pre-fill it so much. So I pre-fill it, you know, just a hair. It's better than nothing. And then what I do is I kind of roll the filter around so that the fibers can soak it up. So I just roll it around a little bit. And you can see, looking into it, there's almost nothing in there now. But I did fill it up pretty good. So that helps with the dry start a little bit, best I can do. So what I'm gonna do, I'll take this back over to the bike and then fish it in same way I took it out, literally with the backside facing me, and then go in. You're gonna turn it at a 90, pretty much right after the silver pump, and then hand tighten it on. Some people like to start backwards, but I've gotten so used to it that I can start in a forward way, just very, very carefully turn it. Then once it engages, I can start turning it on. So I'm gonna get the oil filter put on. I'm gonna tighten it down. I've gotten to the point where I can just feel, I don't need to torque wrench to do it. I think it's like 14 Newton meters or something like that to be able to tighten this down to the torque spec, but I've gotten good enough to where I can just hand tighten it, know where it needs to be, and I'm good to go. And this is, like I said, the OE, or this is the AMSOIL oil filter. So I'm gonna get this put on, and I'll be back and show you the drain process again. Okay, so the oil filter is back on. You can kind of see it in there. Now I'm going back to that drain plug I told you about. Now I'm going to loosen this up again. Move it back a little bit. And allow more oil to come out. So, ooh, that was close. So again, it's not much of a difference, but it's how I was taught, you know, so it's what I do. So I'm gonna let that drain there for a while. I'm also going to open up the fill cap here and take some of my new oil, because this bike calls for like 4.15 quarts. So I'm gonna take some of the quart over there of new oil and pull it into the clutch, pour it into the clutch cover while it's still draining to kind of flush out the oil as well.
You can see up there, I've got a collection of bottles, a lot of Amsoil stuff. I've actually got a couple old bottle quarts here. So, I mean, I could use those. I try to date everything that I buy. I know that I'm going to be using the most of this one here soon on another guy's bike. So I'm just going to use that bottle instead and keep my older stuff over there. So yeah, I'm going to start pouring that in now. And then I will be back. Okay, so I'm back and I poured in some of the fresh oil with the drain plug open. So you can kind of see it coming out here in the clean oil. You can't really see it, but I can see it to my eye. It kind of looks like a tornado of clean and dirty oil. It's kind of cool the way it comes out multicolored, but it kind of just, like I said, flushes out the system. I probably poured in an eighth of a quart, just enough to, you know, push more oil out, more dirty oil out. Again, this is with the oil filter put on, the fill cap open, and then the drain plug out, pour new oil in, and that's basically the concept that I'm working on there. So once this is done draining, for the most part, goes to a drip, I'm gonna put the plug back in, and then I will be back. Okay, so the oil turned into a drip, and then what I did is I went ahead and put the drain plug back in, taking my 17 millimeter socket and making sure righty tighty, lefty loosey. So, going the right way there. Put it on the socket, or on the nut, on the bolt, excuse me, and then tighten it down. I think the torque spec on this is like 45 newton meters. Again, I've done so many bikes and cars that I can't even count. So I just tighten it down to the till I think it's good. So. Which is right there. You don't want to go too tight, because if you bust off this nut, or you strip out the threads, or bust off this nut, if you strip off the threads or whatever, you need a new oil pan. Those can get expensive. Granted, it's probably one of the easier ones to change, but it can get expensive. So, and then when I'm done, what I like to do is I like to grab just a dirty shop towel, wipe off the oil pan, any excess oil around the bolt itself, the header, anything, to kind of clean it up a little bit, because it gets kind of grimy down here and I'm pretty anal about my bike, so I like to make it look as clean as possible. So I get in here and I wipe it down and everything else. So now it's to filling. Now before you fill, you have to make sure that your oil filter's on and your drain plugged in, otherwise you'll just be wasting your money by dumping oil in and watching it go out the other end. So this bike takes, like I said, 4.15 quarts or so. So I'm gonna put in a solid 4 out of my gallon and see where I'm at, because I pre-filled the filter a little bit. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that now. And when I'm back, I'll kind of show you the oil level. Basically, also I wanted to say that I've got a bunch of different oil funnels. I've got one for clean oil, I've got one for dirty oil, I've got another one for brake fluid, and then I've got another one for coolant. So it keeps me from having to clean out my filter, my funnels, and they're like 99 cents a piece, so I just bought a bunch of them. It keeps me from having to clean them out, I keep them separate, and all that good stuff. So I guess that's a little tip for anyone that's constantly cleaning out filters. Just go out, pay $5 and get enough to do everything that you're gonna need to do. So all right, I'm going to fill it right here with a funnel. Nice thing about these little funnels is they well, this one doesn't but they sit in there pretty nice. They fit in the hole perfectly. And then what I'm gonna do is, since I have the camera, I'm gonna have to turn off the camera, but I'm gonna hold it up with one hand, fill it up with the other. I'm gonna use pretty much the whole gallon. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that here, and I'll be back. Okay, so the oil has been put in. Like I said, I used the whole gallon here. Didn't mean to kick it over, but I used the whole gallon. Put the cap back on top of this quart here and hold on to the leftover for buddy's bike, and there we go. So next step is going to be to start the bike, let it warm up, and then I'm gonna check my oil level.
Now,
there are two marks on the sight glass down here. Please focus camera. That's pretty good. There's a mark here and a mark here. The goal is to shoot to be right between it. I personally like to go on the high side. I've had my oil light come on before under hard acceleration when I was right in the middle. So I try to put it on the higher side so that my glass is half full. There's actually a tick mark right in the middle. I like to be just above that. So some guys will just go right in the middle. I like to go on the higher side. So let's see if I can zoom in on it here so you can see the little tick mark in the middle. So lower line, upper line, middle. So that's kind of what I like to go for. But like I said, I'm gonna start with the bike here and then let it run. Okay. Then. So I'm gonna let it run for 5 to 10 minutes or so. Double check my oil level. Let me step out of here so you can actually hear me. So I'm gonna let it run for 5 or 10 minutes or so. Double check the oil level and then should be good to go. I'll show the oil level once I'm done. Okay, so I ran the bike for about 5-10 minutes. Give me time to clean up, pick up, put all the panels back on again down there on the bottom and everything else. So, but give you an idea of where I keep my level. So as you can see, it's about just halfway, just over halfway. So that's where I keep my level. And yeah, that's all there is to changing oil on a 09 to current R1. Also what I like to do is get some quick detailer when I'm done and spray down the panels that my oily hands were on, in any other place. I still have the touch there, and oil cap and everything else, but I'd clean up all the excess oil on the different panels and whatnot. So if you have any questions, let me know. Again, I use the AMSOIL filter, AMSOIL 10W40, full synthetic motorcycle oil, which is wet clutch compatible. So find an oil you like and do it yourself. Save you a bunch of money, save you time. And yeah, if you have any questions, let me know. Thanks, guys. See ya.